gray colored. So what happened here? Then if you go to the F2 generation, means VG plus VG, B plus B, plus if you take black winged as well as vestigial like this. So VG, VG and B, B. So this is black winged and vestigial. So this is F1 generation individual. If you do breeding between these two, crossbreed, then the individuals produced are, majority of the individuals have similarity with parents. They have similarity with the parents. So means finally, some of the characters transmission in an individual are genetically linked. Means body size, body color and wings size in the Drosophila are genetically linked characters. Their transmission is genetically linked. So this is the character studied by the Morgan Huff, linkage effects. Okay, right. So let us see one more thing in the genetics, that is pleiotropy. Sir, what is pleiotropy? Sir, as per genetics principles, one gene controls one character. One gene controls how many characters? One characters. One character. Sir, here, besides this principle, it is not always correct. One gene may control more than one character. One gene may control more than one character. That is called as pleiotropy. The multiple effects of a single gene is called as pleiotropy. Sir, actually in the pleiotropy, as per Mendel, one gene controls only how many characters? One character. But this is not always true. So one gene controls more than one character. So this is called as multiple effects of a single gene and more number of characters is called as pleiotropy. Sir, if you take example for the pleiotropy, it is called as phenylketonuria is an example. Phenylketonuria. Sir, if you take phenylketonuria, it is a disease. Due to the lack of an enzyme, phenylalanine hydroxylase. Sir, actually, if you take the process, phenylalanine, sir, phenylalanine, this is one amino acid. Phenylalanine is converted into tyrosine. It is converted into what? Tyrosine. So in the presence of which one? Phenylalanine hydroxylase enzyme. Okay. So in the presence of phenylalanine hydroxylase enzyme, phenylalanine is converted into tyrosine. Sir, when a gene which controls phenylalanine hydroxylase is damaged, phenylalanine is not converted into tyrosine. Phenylalanine is converted into phenylpyruvic acid. Phenylpyruvic acid. So phenylalanine is converted into phenylpyruvic acid. So this phenylpyruvic acid is accumulated in the body. So this kind of accumulation of phenylpyruvic acid in the body leads to the mental retardation and loss of hair and loss of pigmentation of skin. So here, mental retardation. Mental retardation. Next, loss of hair on the body, so on the head. Next one, loss of skin pigmentation. Okay, so here means the gene which is responsible for the phenylalanine hydroxylase was damaged. Phenylalanine cannot be converted into tyrosine and it is converted into phenylpyruvic acid. The accumulation of phenylpyruvic acid in the body is called as phenylketonuria. It is called as what? Phenylketonuria. Sir, the gene which is responsible for the phenylalanine hydroxylase also controls some other characters. Okay, means the genes always controls a character, but some genes controls more than one character. And the characters controlled by the same gene, cystic fibrosis and sickle cell anemia. Sir, here means the gene which is responsible for the phenylalanine hydroxylase also controls cystic fibrosis as well as sickle cell anemia. So this is called as phenylketonuria disease, and it is called as pleiotropy. Means what is pleiotropy? Some of the genes controls more than one character. This kind of multiple effects of a single gene on more number of characters is known as pleiotropy. Here we have taken example phenylketonuria disease. Actually, what is happening in the phenylketonuria? See, phenylalanine must be converted into tyrosine in the presence of phenylalanine hydroxylase enzyme. So when the phenylalanine hydroxylase enzyme coding gene is damaged, then what happens? Phenylalanine hydroxylase is not produced. Then phenylalanine converted into phenylpyruvic acid or phenylpyruvate. So when this phenylpyruvate is accumulated in our body, so this symptom is called as phenylketonuria. So the symptoms of phenylketonuria: mental retardation, there is no psychological development, loss of hair and loss of skin pigmentation are the symptoms. This gene not only controls phenyl hydroxylase enzyme synthesis, but also controls some other characters like cystic fibrosis and sickle cell anemia. So this is called as pleiotropy.